In this video, we are going to take a closer look at aperture. Aperture is a mechanical diaphragm that opens wider to allow more light and closes smaller to reduce the amount of light entering the camera. The aperture is normally measured in f-stops of light. The scale may seem counterintuitive, as the larger the f-stop value, the smaller the opening and the less light that comes in. For example, an f5.6 lets in less light and is a smaller opening than an f1.4. Common f-stops are 1.0, 1.4, 2, 2.8, 4, 5.6, 8, 11, 16, and 22. Most quality lenses open up to between an f4 and an f2.8, although you might find some lenses that go all the way to a 0.95. Some zoom lenses have variable maximum apertures, meaning that the aperture changes how wide it can open for different focal lengths. A common variable lens aperture is 3.5 to 5.6. You can find the maximum aperture imprinted on every lens. Aperture is a good gauge of lens quality. Fixed apertures and faster apertures both indicate higher quality lenses and provide more options to the photographer. In addition to the amount of light entering the camera, aperture also has a very important secondary effect. Aperture adjusts the depth of field. Depth of field is a measure of how much depth is in focus. The wider the aperture, the shallower the depth of field. A shallow depth of field can result in a subject's eye being in focus while their nose is out of focus, because only half of an inch of depth is in focus. The smaller the aperture, the deeper the depth of field will be. Deep focus can have a tree and a mountain a mile behind the tree both in focus. Changing the aperture allows you to achieve different depths of field with your image. Aperture always has to be balanced out by shutter and ISO to create proper exposure. Thanks for joining me today, and please check out our other church technology resources available at academyav.com.